Now slowly open your eyes, rub your palm, place it on your eyes, rub it on your face, neck, shoulder, and keep it on your laps. You know why we do yoga every day in the morning, na? Meditation, because it makes our mind fresh and ready to learn. So I'm sure now after this short session of yoga, you all are ready to learn the new thing which we are going to do today. Now today we are having two very interesting topics to do. Now first I want to introduce some very interesting person to you, and this person, you know, he always bothers us, especially the children, because this person is always used by our mom for so many times a day. Okay, now when will you finish your homework? When are you going to get up and brush your teeth? When are you going to finish your food? Why are you not learning? What are you doing? This thing we are hearing now throughout the day from your mom, correct? That is the person which we are going to meet today. This is Mr. Question. Now, Mr. Question is someone who has got always something to ask. No matter how much you answer him, no matter how much you try to listen to him and answer back, but he always has something or the other to ask, and that is why I can see that he is always confused, because he is always looking for one person. What is he looking for? Mr. Question is always looking for answers. Okay, so Mr. Question always wants answers. Now why he wants answers? Because unless and until he gets the answers, he'll keep on asking, and that is what we are going to learn today, is about the question mark. Okay, you must have seen this in your test papers. Whenever teacher gives you a test, everywhere you can see these questions, and these questions bother you also, correct? The school, the teacher is giving you these questions, they bother you. And so mama is not putting this question mark, but mama is always questioning you. Correct. So this Mr. Question, even though he might irritate us sometimes, but he's also very important for all of us. Why is very important for all of us? It's because unless and until we find out the answer to these questions, there are so many things we cannot find out. You all don't know, when you're very small, you all used to ask so many questions to your parents, and your parents, without getting irritated, they used to answer all of them. Mama, why is the moon up in the sky? Why can't I bring it down? Mama, why this thing is here? Who is doing this? So there are so many things we ask, because unless until you ask questions, you're not going to learn new things. Okay, so that is the importance of questions for all of us. And every question, as I told you, needs an answer. So today, first we are going to learn what type of questions are there. Actually, there are questions which are using the W words. Most of the questions begin with the W questions. Okay, like who, where, when, what, which, all these are W questions. And these W questions, they answer so many things for us. Now, each and every W word, what question it asks, and in return for that, what answer it's expecting, is what I'm going to show you through a small presentation. Okay, so I want everyone to be attentive, fold your hands and sit quietly, and look carefully and listen to the teacher as she explains each and everything about question. Why I'm telling you this is because after you learn how to frame these questions, where to use these questions, we are going to have a small activity in which you will have to frame questions. Okay, so everyone, be attentive, pay attention, and look at the presentation very carefully. Here begins our question world. Now, in this world of question, there are so many questions which we also have. Right now, there are so many questions going in our mind. Now, as the presentation progresses, you will come to know that at present also, there are so many questions in our mind. What, who, when, where, why? Why are we locked at home? When will this get over? There are so many questions in our mind. Some we have answers, but for some, we are still searching for answers, right? So let us find when to use which question word. So we first begin with the question word, who. Now the child can see on the screen is none other than you people. Now like, when I am asking the question who, I'm talking about a person. I'm talking about whom? Talking about a person. Who is this? Second question word is what? Okay, so let us first all the question words, then we will see that which question word is used for finding what. Third question word is where? Where are you going? Where are you looking? The next question word is when? When do you get up? You know that you have early classes in the morning. Mama woke you up or you got up on your own. Okay. Now the next question word after when is why? So we saw the question words. Question words are who, what, when, and when. Now one by one, let's look at in what they are used. First is who. Now, who question words ask to find out who a particular person is. Like, for example, if I show you the photograph of a person and ask you, who is this? You will be able to recognize that this is, suppose I show you a photograph of Sachin Tendulkar, you will say, this is Sachin Tendulkar. Or if I show you a picture of a particular food item, okay? So when I'm asking about some person, when I'm showing food item, you cannot say who is this. Okay, so who is used for a person. Okay, now next. Sir, what happened to the presentation? Can we play it again? Can we play the presentation again? So after who, the next question was what? Now what is used to find out about something? Now what is this? What is that? When, where, when, why, and the last question word is how. Now, one by one, we will see where these question words are used. First, begin with who. As I told you, who is used to find out about a person. These are very important questions. Okay. Now, we begin with who. Now, when I say who, it finds out about a person. Now, you will see a particular picture on screen. You have to find who that person is and give me the answer. Right? Now, first, let's look at who. Now, who tells us about a person, animal, or creature? You can identify a person, animal, or creature by asking the question, who? Next. For example, who is he? The picture you see on the screen, you can see an image on the screen. I'm sure many of us recognize him. If you don't recognize him, that means you're not watching the news and you're not knowing the current affairs, which you all must know. Who is he? He is our Chief Minister, Uddhav Thackeray. Now, you can see more important person. Yes, he's Uddhav Thackeray. Correct answer. Now, next, I'm going to show you one more very famous person. I'm sure everyone of you will know this person very well. The image you see on the screen, try to identify. Who is she? Have you seen this face? If you have not seen this, I'm sure you must definitely heard her voice. She's also called Kokila of India. Okay, she is a very, very famous singer, Lata Mangeshkar. Next. Who are they? First, we ask about a single person, a man and a woman. Now, we can also ask about people in group. The who question. Who are they? Just try to find out who are they. Look the picture carefully and find out. Yes, these are the people who are helping us out these days. In this particular hard times, these are our health workers. Very good. Correct answer. Now, these are the health workers who are helping us out. Even though we are all sitting at home, these health workers are working 24/7 for our betterment, for us. Right? So, this is how we find out about a person, creature, or animal by asking the questions who. Now, next we move to the question word what. Now, what question word is used to find out about? Everyone knows, yes, about the things. We find out about the things by asking the question, what? Or we also get information. As I told you, you were very small. You used to ask so many questions. Even now, what is this? What is this? Ask so many questions. What is happening over there? So we get all the information by using the question word, what? As I said, what is this? You can see an image on the screen. Now, I'm sure all of you recognize this. You can find out about a thing. What is this? Correct. This is a pencil. This is a pencil. Next. What is that? Can you see the difference between things? When I asked you, what is this? The thing was near me. Okay. So I've learned this concept, near and far. Near and far. So when the things are near us, we ask, what is this? And by the way, we ask the question, what is that? So now, the object remains the same, but the distance has changed. So what is that? That's a pencil. Now, if you have got so many things in lunch, then will we ask, what are this or what is that? Okay. Now, if you are not having only one pencil, you are having a bunch of pencils, what will be your question? What are these? Then I will say, these are pencils. Okay. So here, also your concept of near and far has to be clear when you are asking about what. If something is near you, you will ask your teacher, what is this, teacher? If something is far away, you will ask the teacher, what is that? Okay. Now, the next question word is where. Now, where is the question word? Where? Okay, when I have to find out something, where is my pencil? Where are my books? Where is my uniform? So many questions we ask in a day, no? And there are so many questions which your mama has to listen every day from every person in the family. Okay, so where tells us about the places or locations where a particular place is or where a particular thing is. Where is that? Is it over here? No, it is not over here. It is over there. Okay. So the answers for where can be very much nearby also. When I say location, it does not mean I'm talking about some faraway places. Now, where are my books? Are they kept here? No, they are kept over there in the shelf. Right? So where answer? Next. Now you can see a table in front of you. Now, can you see a cat here? Yes. Where is the cat? Correct. The cat is under the table. Where is the cat? The cat is under the table. You got the location of the cat. Correct. Next. Where is Gateway of India? I am sure now you're not going out, but all of us have visited this once in a at least. Okay, so where is Gateway of India? Gateway of India is in Mumbai. Gateway of India is in Mumbai. So where question word answers about the places or locations. The next question word is when. Now, when is the question word which tells you about a particular time? When did this thing happen? Or when this was, when is your birthday? When will this particular thing happen? It tells you about the time. Next. As you can see, the ticking of the clock. The when question word tells you about the time, about the date. You look at the calendar and you try to find out so many things. when is your birthday, when is your friend's birthday, or when is this going to event going to happen, when is this particular party. Nowadays we don't have party anyhow, but still when tells you about the dates and the time. Next. Now let us see some when questions which are going through our mind. Now the first when question, when is your birthday, which we all are very curious to answer. This is one thing answer which we all want to give others. When is your birthday, we also like to answer, and we also like to ask question to our friends. We want to wish our friends, no? So we keep on asking them, when is your birthday. Another when question which is going on nowadays is, now when is your birthday, it's in November, not mine but the child who you first saw in the screen. Now another when question which is going on in everyone's mind, when will the school begin? We know that we all are learning online, but we all are craving to go back to school. But sorry for this, there is no answer, right? We don't know when the school will begin, but we are all very sure that very soon the school will begin and we all will be together again in the classroom in the same environment. Okay, so these are the when questions. Now, when do you play? At home also, we cannot play throughout the day. So mama has fixed a time for us. So when do you play? What time do you play? You play it in the... When do you play usually? We play in the evening. Correct. We usually morning times of a study. And when do we play? We play in the evening, even when the schools are going on. Right? Now, after when comes the very important question word, that is why. Now, why is... Now, why is why a very important question word? Let me tell you the reason. When someone asks you a who, you can easily answer that, yes, this is a person. When someone asks you what, you can easily answer, yes, this is about a particular thing. When someone asks, you can give a particular word. Okay. When someone asks you when, you can easily tell the time when this thing will occur. But when you are asked a question why, then we have to give a reason. We have to think and tell a reason. That is why the why questions are very important, and you have to think over for this. You just cannot answer. If suppose you have come to the class and you have not done your homework, teacher will ask you, why have you not finished your homework? Can you say yes or no for that? No, you have to find a proper reason and answer. The teacher could not complete my homework because I was not well, or my book was incomplete, I was not having a proper notebook. Okay, so why questions, you have to give proper answers. Why is it so hot? If someone asks you a question, why is it so hot? The answer for that will be, you have to think and say, why is it hot? Either the fan is not working, or it is a... When do you feel very hot? Correct. You feel very hot in the summer season. So why is it so hot? It is hot because it is a summer season. Next. Correct. Because it is summer. Let us see another why question. Why are you walking so fast? Usually in the mornings, we see that children walk very fast while going to the school. Yes, because I am late to school. If you are walking fast, there is a reason for that. Why are you walking fast? Because I am late to school. Why do you want money? You cannot ask for money without reason. Okay, so if you're asking for money to anyone, there has to be reason for it. You have to give a reason for it. Why do you want money? The answer is, I want to buy books. Why you want money? Because I want to buy books. So these are our questions which give the answer to why. Now, the next and the last question word we are going to do today is how. Now, how gives us explanation about something. How are you? When someone asks, how are you? You are going to explain that how are you feeling? And in return, we ask, how about you? So how question word gives us an explanation. Okay, let us see another how question. How is the weather today? You have to explain. Yes, how is the weather today? Yes, it is very cold and windy, or it is very hot and I'm sweating a lot. So it is very cold and windy. So how is the weather? You can give some information. You are going to tell something about the weather. So these are all the question words. How old are you? You have to tell your age. How old are you? You have to tell your age. You have to tell about your age. Okay, so all these are the question words which we have done today. Now let us take a just short recap of all these question words so that we can move on to our activities. Correct. When you are asked how old are you, because you're in third standard, most of you are either 7 years old or 8 years old. Now let us look at the all the question words and have a short quiz on this. Now, this is a small activity which you all have to think. Now, here you will be given a blank and you are going to find out what question word will come here. Now, to help you all, I am going to give you an answer for it. Below will be the answer, and looking at the answer, you have to find out what question word is going to fit over here. Dash, are you going to the party? The answer is, I am going to the party at 6 p.m. Now, can I say, what are you going to the party? Or who are you going to the party? Or which are you going to the party? No. So what will be the answer over here? Because you're giving the answer as time. So the question word will be, when are you going to the party? Very good. Correct answer. Second question. When are you going to the party? Dash is your book. Let us see at the answer. What is the answer over here? Here it is, ma'am. Rahil has answered already. Now, when teacher says, dash is your book, the answer given by Rahil, here it is, ma'am. Now, what will be the answer word according to you? Who is your book? Very good. Correct. The question word is, where is your book? Where is your book? Correct. Now, next question. Dash many days are there in a week? When someone is telling you, dash many days are there in a week? And the answer is, there are 7 days in a week. So what will be the question? Yes. How many days are there in a week? Next. Now, here is a small paragraph for you in which there is a conversation between mom and dad. Okay, so I'm just going to read this paragraph for you and we'll try to find out what question words mom and this son, her son are using over here. Now, mom, dash broke the window pane. You can see a broken window pane here. Son said, I don't know, ma. So what should be the question? Who broke the window pane? Mom, oh, really? Son, it must have broken on its own. Mom, dash, are you lying to me? You can see here the son giving an explanation. I didn't want to be scolded. What did mom ask? Yes, he's giving a reason. So mom asked, why are you lying to me? So the son replied, I didn't want to get scolded. Next, mom says, dash, did it break? I was playing in the room with the ball. I hit it accidentally. So mom asked, how did it break? I was playing in the room with the ball and I hit it accidentally. Dash, many times have I told you not to play in the room, but you never listen. Sorry, ma, I will never repeat it. What did mom ask? How many times have I told you not to play in the room, but you never listen? Okay. So like that, I'm going to give you one more paragraph in which I'm going to leave the blank for your questions, and let us see how many of you have understood those question words well, right? Now, since we all know these question words very well, now, as I had told you, we will move on to another activity, that why I have explained you the question words today. Now, we learned the question words today because we have to learn about using these question words. When will I use these question words? How will I use these question words? Now, these questions are also coming in my mind. Now, these question words I can use when I am writing a picture composition which teacher has given me. Teacher gives me a picture to describe. Now, I don't know how to describe this picture. I just keep on looking at it and wondering. But now, since we all know the question words, we can find out by asking the questions, right? Now, I'm going to show you a small beach. Okay, now all of you can see this. This is a seashore. Okay, now what you can see on the screen right now is a seashore, right? Now, when I look at this seashore, I can ask so many questions and I can find out the answers to it. Okay, now you can see there are so many things happening on the seashore. There are so many activities happening on the seashore. If I have to describe this, when I look at it, yes, I can find out. But how to describe this? Now, to describe this, I need to find out the questions to my, I need to ask questions and find out the answers for it. Okay, so let us find out the questions one by one. Now, suppose I'm asking you a question, how many children are there on the beach? Now, we can count, there are so many children. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12 children are there. Children are there on the beach. Sorry. There are 12 children on the beach. Now you can see an ice cream seller here. Yes. What is the ice cream seller doing? He is selling an ice cream. Now, how many children are swimming? There are 3 children swimming. Sir, PPT afterwards. Right? So when I look at this, then I can describe the picture so well. Now I'm going to ask questions about these beach and we are going to find out the answers for it. Now, as I told you, we are doing the picture composition. Now, the first question is, what is this picture of? This is the picture of a beach. Okay, so I got my first sentence. Now, second question. What are the children doing on the beach? What are the children doing on the beach? The children are playing on the beach. So if I ask the questions, I get the answers and I can form sentences. So what are the children doing on the beach? The children are playing on the beach. What are they doing? They are playing. Now, third question. How many children are there on the beach? So I can count and easily write down that how many children are there. We counted here just now. There are 12 children on the beach. How many children are there? There are 12 children on the beach. So when I have already learned the question words, it becomes very easy for me to write the answers and form sentences. Now, if suppose I ask that who is selling the ice cream on the beach? You can see the person here. Who is selling the ice cream on the beach? Correct. Who is selling the ice cream on the beach? There is an ice cream seller who is selling the ice cream on the beach. So who is selling the ice cream? An ice cream seller is selling the ice cream on the beach. Now, my next question will be, what can I ask? Yes. You know, one more thing, when we are writing picture composition, we can give name to the characters. The children who are here, we can give the names of our own friends, or we can give any name we like, and we can frame the picture composition. Now, for example, here I can see two children playing with the ball. Okay, so my question is about these two children, that what are they doing? What are Rahul and Sania doing with the ball? Rahul and Sania are playing with the ball. What are Rahul and Sania doing with the ball? Rahul and Sania are playing with the ball. What is Tina giving? Whom is Tina giving the ice cream? You can see here Tina offering the ice cream to someone. Yes, she is offering the ice cream to a crab. You know, we can see so many crabs on the beach, no? So what is Tina doing? She is offering her ice cream to a crab. So see how we have framed these six sentences by asking the questions. Okay? So it becomes very easy for us to frame the, write the picture composition when you know to frame the questions. Okay? So my first question was, what is this picture of? This is the picture of a beach. What are the children doing on the beach? Children are playing on the beach. How many children are there on the beach? There are 12 children on the beach. Who is selling ice cream on the beach? An ice cream seller is selling ice cream on the beach. What are Rahul and Sania doing with the ball? Rahul and Sania are playing with the ball. Whom is Tina offering the ice cream? Tina is giving the ice cream to a crab. Now, in the same way, we can ask more questions and we can frame more sentences and complete our picture composition. As you can see here, I can also ask the question. Now, who has brought a dog on the beach? You can see here, a boy has brought a dog on the beach. So I can give a name to this character and say that Tom has brought his dog on the beach. Okay. Who has brought the dog on the beach? Tom has brought the dog on the beach. Okay. Then other questions also we can ask. Huh? We can ask the question, what is Tina doing under the umbrella? Tina is sitting and taking rest under the umbrella. Now, what are Pooja and Ahmed doing with the sand over here? As you can see, Pooja and Ahmed are building a sand castle. What are Pooja and Ahmed doing? They are building a sand castle. And last, we can sum up by asking about the entire children, that what are the children doing on this beach? So you can say all the children are having fun on the beach. Okay, so like that, we can put all the sentences and finally write it in the form of a paragraph and frame our picture composition. Okay, so it becomes very easy for us to frame the picture composition if we know all the question words. We can find out the answers to our questions and complete our picture composition. Okay, so like that, I have got 10 sentences, and all these 10 sentences, you can write it in the form of a paragraph, and you can give a nice title to it, and you can write your picture composition. Now, step by step, how to write this picture composition, I'm going to explain you with the help of this PPT. Now, everyone is going to pay attention and with their hands folded. Sir, we can start the PPT now. Now, what is this? It is a picture composition. Okay. Now, first thing what you will see on the screen is you're going to see a picture. You know that every picture has something to tell us. It describes us something. Okay. But how will I find out what is there in the picture? I can find out about the picture and write a composition on that only when I ask questions and try to find out. Now, see the second picture. You can see here there are so many children. Now, if I ask you, what are these children doing? These children are playing Holi. How many children are playing Holi? There are 6 children who are playing Holi. Okay, so if you can frame the questions and answer the find out the answers for that, you will be able to write down a picture composition very easily. Now, let us see at the other picture. Okay, so what is the picture composition? Consists of writing sentences, right? Now, let us see what is a picture composition definition. Now, what a picture composition does, it for that, we have to first observe the picture very carefully. And then we have to describe it in the form of a composition. Now, as I showed you the sentences, first we have to frame the sentences by asking questions. And then we can arrange it properly in the form of a paragraph. Now, you all are grown-up children, no? Third standard. So you cannot write it point-wise. So we have to arrange it in the form of a paragraph. You can see this picture over here. There are so many things in this picture. Now, how will I find out how to describe this picture? I just cannot write in a haste. I have to first observe it very carefully. What all things are there which I can describe? So first thing that I see in the picture is that the children are playing and having fun. What is this picture of? This is the picture of a garden. What can I see in the sky? You can see a rainbow in the sky. Okay. Now, Tina is cuddling which pet? She is cuddling a cat, right? Now, after whom is this running? Yes, the boy was running after a girl. So this is how when you frame the entire sentences, we can write down the picture composition very well. Now, how do you write a composition is a very important part. Okay, now you have to pay attention that how will you write a composition properly? The first thing is, you have to carefully observe the picture. Okay. Whenever teacher gives you composition, picture composition, first thing you have to do is observe that picture carefully. Take your own time. Don't be in a hurry. Second thing, you have to observe all the things or actions you see. Right? You have to see what is happening in this picture. Observe everything carefully. What all things are there? Every minute thing, even a small ant you can see. Observe what is the ant doing. Suppose the ant is going near an apple, right? So you can describe that also. Small, small details you can see. Next comes the part which we did just now. Why I explained you? Because you have to ask questions and note down the answers or observations to these questions. Okay, so whatever I have asked, all those questions, I have to find out the answers and I have to write down point-wise. Next. I have to arrange all the observation as points in a proper order. I cannot just write anything in any order. Okay. So I have to observe these pictures carefully, ask questions and arrange it in proper order. Now, for example, when I was explaining about the beach, I cannot immediately start my composition by saying that the children are all having fun on the beach. First, I have to tell what is this picture of? So this is the picture of a beach. Okay, so sequence wise, you ask the questions, write the answers and arrange it in a proper order. Then you have to write meaningful sentences to form a composition. Your framing of sentences, we have already done, no? In the beginning of the year itself, how to frame a sentence. A sentence always begins with a capital letter, ends with a full stop. So always remember that you have to frame proper complete sentences, no group of words. It has to be a sentence. Now, you all know the difference between group of words and sentences, no? Correct. So, it has to be a complete sentence. It starts with capital letter, ends with a full stop. And as I told you, when you've written the entire composition, write a title to the composition based on the main theme of the picture. Like, for example, my beach picture, I can give the title as Fun on the Beach or A Day on the Beach. An evening on the beach, right? So when you see the entire theme of the picture, you can give a title to that picture composition. Now let us see an example of how to write a picture composition with the help of a picture. Now you can see this picture on the screen. Now first thing I have to do is I have to observe this picture carefully. Okay, I have to see all the details of a picture. Then one by one comes my questions. Correct. One by one I will ask questions and write down the answers for it. What is this picture of? Answer. This is the picture of a park where the children are having fun. My first answer and question are done. Second question. What is happening in the picture? You can see it is a picture, but what is happening in this picture? The answer for that is the children are playing in the park. Okay, the children are not sitting and studying over there. They're not drawing over there. They're not eating over there. What are the children doing? You can see all the children having fun in different way. So what is happening in the picture? The children are playing in the park. Next question. How many children are there in the park? Okay, now I have to count how many children only, not the grown-ups. Okay, so I count down the number of children and write down my third sentence. There are, how many children are there? Did you count? Yes, there are 6 children in the park. How many are there? There are 6 children in the park. Now let us find out my next question that I can ask. What are Rohit and Shinu doing? Now, when I say Rohit and Shinu doing, this means that is a boy and a girl playing together. Okay. Now, as I told you, we can give any name to the characters. It can be your friend's name, anyone's name. So, what are Rohit and Shinu doing? I have given this name to the children who are on the tree. So, Rohit and Shinu are playing on the tree. My next question. What is Granny doing? You can see who is Granny in the picture? Correct. So what is Granny doing? Granny is, what will be the answer? Yes. Granny is telling a story to Nina. You can see she is having a book in her hand, right? So what is Granny doing? She is telling a story to Nina. Nina is a little girl who is sitting next to Granny. And the Granny is reading a story for her. Okay. Now, my next question, what is the puppy doing? You can see a puppy also, right, in the picture. As I said, you have to observe each and every detail of the picture. So what is the puppy doing? Correct. The puppy is playing with Aman and Richa. Now see, I have given name to these two kids as well. The boy is Aman and the girl is Richa. So what is the puppy doing? He is playing with Aman and Richa. Okay. So I've got so many sentences now. Now the time is to find out the last and concluding sentence for this. And we can write the entire picture composition. Okay. As I told you, it is written in the form of a paragraph. And teacher has already explained to you that you always begin a paragraph by leaving a 2-finger space. Okay. So you leave 2-finger space and start your paragraph. This is the picture of a park. There are 6 children at the park. They're having fun out here. They are playing around. Rohit and Shinu are friends. They are climbing on the tree. They are playing on it. Nina has come to the park with her granny and cousin Chintu. Granny is telling her a story sitting on the bench. Chintu is standing behind them. Aman and Richa are playing with the puppy. Richa is riding her 2-wheeler scooter. It's a great fun in the park. So see, I have written all the sentences and I've tried to write it in the descriptive form. I have just not stuck to the sentences. This is a picture of a park. There are 6 children. Rohit and Shinu are doing. I have added details. Okay. So you can use your own imagination. Okay. What is composition? It is nothing but imaginative writing. So you have to use your own imagination. Now, why Rohit and Shinu are only climbing the tree? Because they are friends. Okay, so I have added a sentence that they are playing around. Rohit and Shinu are friends and that is why they are climbing on the tree. Nina has come to the park with her granny and cousin Chintu. Now, from where has Chintu come? I did not ask him in the question about him in the question, but the boy who is standing behind the bench, I can always imagine that they are supposed to be from the same family, right? Nina is sitting next to Granny and Shintu is listening the story from the behind, right? So you have to use your own imagination, ask questions and frame the composition. Now let us see what all we have learned today. As I told, we can give the title. So I gave the title to that composition as Fun in the Park. Now, what did we learn today? We learned that a picture composition is an exercise where you describe picture by writing meaningful sentences about it. Okay, what is picture composition? It is an exercise where you have to describe the picture by writing meaningful sentences about it. They have to be sensible and meaningful sentences. Second, a picture composition consists of writing a few meaningful sentences or a paragraph, right? You will always begin with sentences and then try to put it in the form of a paragraph. Next, we have learned today that before you begin writing the composition, you have to observe the composition very carefully. This is the most important part. Only when you observe carefully will you be able to ask questions, and then only you can write down the answers as points in the logical order. Next, what we learned today is that write a title to the composition based on the main theme of the picture. You will always get a picture either of a park or a garden or a seashore, anything, or a marketplace, something which is known to you. So when you see all the details of the picture, then you can give a suitable title to the composition based on the main theme of the picture. Next. And the most important part we have learned today is that when you are writing the composition, you cannot begin from the beginning. The sentence has to be written by leaving 2 finger space and you write it in the form of a paragraph. Okay, so this is how we write a picture composition. Okay, so everyone I'm sure has understood now how to write a picture composition. Right, so just a short recap, what did we learn today? We learned today first about our Mr. Question Mark, and we learned that how he is confused and how we can satisfy his confusion by asking the questions. Okay, and these questions are going to help us in getting the answers, and we can frame a picture composition by answering these questions, right? So now today I have explained you one picture composition with the help of your PPT. I've also explained you picture composition with the help of this beach image over here. Now I'm giving you one activity, a picture composition, which you have to observe very carefully. And then you have to write sentences on this. You have to ask questions and write sentences on this. I'm going to send you this image. You have to see it very carefully. All the details of the beach. What are the children doing over here? What is the girl doing under the umbrella? You can see so many things. A crab is there. A bird is there. So all these details you have to observe very carefully, and you're going to write sentences on that. Okay, so this is what we have done today, asking question words and framing sentences and writing the picture composition with the help of that, right? So revise that and you're going to finish that composition, and I'm going to ask you in the next session. And as I told you, we are going to have one quiz again about the question words. Be prepared for that. Okay, thank you, and we are done for the day. Bye, children.